Okay, guys. I hope everybody can hear me. Thank you all for joining me today. I'm so excited to be here and speak at DevReach in front of such a great audience. Now I'm going to tell you a few words about me. My name is Atanas Poptanasov, and I'm a software engineer working for Telerik Progress. This is a company that is well known among the .NET developers for the beautiful and feature-rich controls we are providing. Currently, I'm part of the UWP and Xamarin team, and previously worked for the Windows Presentation Foundation team. I have some work experience in WinForms as well. So from that short bio, I believe you can assume that today we're going to talk about desktop, and more specifically, how you can enhance your existing WPF or Windows Forms app using the features that are provided by the Universal Windows Platform. Okay. First, I'm going to talk about different options you nowadays have as a .NET developer for building desktop apps. I have already mentioned them. These are WPF, WinForms, and UWP. But that simple introduction will be very important for my next slide, which is what actually UWP gives us more comparing that technology to the other two technologies. After that, I'm going to talk about the options of enhancement. Is it possible to enhance your existing WPF or WinForms app using the features that are provided by UWP? We'll know that in a few minutes. After that, I'm going to tell you a few words about Desktop Bridge and how it is connected with the options of enhancement. What part actually that Desktop Bridge plays in the enhancement process. Next, I will talk about the XAML Islands. That is something I'm very excited about because it was actually released a few weeks ago with the latest version of Windows. And I'm going to show you a demo how XAML Islands could be used and could help you invoke controls, which are pure native UWP controls from within your WPF or WinForms app. And finally, I'm going to talk about the future of the desktop development. Of course, if you have some minutes at the end, we'll have some Q&A. All right, nowadays it's very exciting to be a desktop developer. You have a great variety of options from you can choose to build your app. Of course, the oldest one is WinForms. WinForms was introduced back in 2002, and believe it or not, people are still developing new apps, not only supporting legacy apps, but they're using WinForms for building new and future-rich apps. It is still supported by Microsoft. They're adding features to it, fixing some bugs. For example, the high DPI support was added recently. It also has some extensive documentation, and most importantly, third-party controls, which help you build your, complete scenario in your application. But 4 years later, WPF was introduced. Comparing WPF to WinForms, what actually WPF gives us more is the direct hex rendering, comparing to the one WinForms has, which is the GDI one. But I believe the most important thing about WPF is the XAML, Extensible Application Markup Language, which makes it easier to distinguish your front-end logic from your back-end logic. And of course, since the technology is 12 years older, it has a lot of documentation and resources available and lots of third-party controls. And 3 years ago, Microsoft released a new technology called Universal Windows Platform. Universal Windows Platform is not a pure desktop technology. Actually, it is a technology for building cross-platform applications that can run on IoT, Xbox, HoloLens, may rest in peace, Windows Mobile, and desktop. Yeah. It is only developed on machines that has Windows 10 installed on them. And like the WPF, it also has support for XAML and highly advanced data bindings. One minus for UWP is the lack of third-party controls. But I'm going to share something very interesting for you. If you are a UWP developer and currently building a UWP app, 2 years ago, Telerik open source all of its UWP controls. The source code can be found in GitHub. Simply go and type UI for UWP, and you will find the repository. There is a NuGet package that you can easily reference into your application and use all of our controls out of the box. We have some great controls here, like data grid, data form, lots of charge gauges, and many more. So you can check it. All right. But what actually UWP gives us more comparing to the R2 technologies? Why a developer should choose UWP when he starts to build his application? Because we have two mature technologies, WinForms and WPF. OK. I basically summarized the features UWP has more comparing to the R2 technologies. And the first thing is the consistent UI look and feel that the technology has with the operating system. 2 years ago at build, the Fluent design was introduced. And basically, that design is integrated into the UWP framework. It comes out of the box. So you can use it without any concerns and without the need to do an additional coding. The next thing is the model features and engagement improvements the framework provides. These are features like toss notification, push notification, lifetiles, speech recognition, and many more. These APIs are, again, integrated directly in UWP and could be used out of the box. And the last thing is improved servicing. What I mean by improved servicing is the ability to package your application into an Apex package, and that package could easily be deployed to the Windows Store. Every machine that runs Windows on it has the store installed. And basically, it's easy for the people to find your application in the store. Of course, the store provides some more features like pricing, which gives the ability to make a specific feature of your application paid, for example. And after paying some amount of money to be able to use that feature. All right. So is it possible to use all of these, may I say, features, improvements, functionalities of UWP from within your WPF or WinForms app? And the answer is yes. Almost every Windows 10 API could be invoked from within the WPF or WinForms app. And it's super easy, just a few references needs to be added. The desktop bridge is technology that gives the ability to package your WPF or Windows Forms app into an Apex package and to deploy it to the store. And finally, the XAML Islands gives you the ability to use a pure controls UWP directly from your WPF or WinForms app. This gives you the consistent UI look and feel with the operating system. So I will start with the Windows 10 APIs. Before calling a Windows 10 API, I suggest you to check whether that API is not present in the framework you're using, the WPF or WinForms, because I have seen many times that people just rushed, take the API, add some references of UWP, and that API actually exists in the WPF or the WinForms world. So please check it. If that API does not exist, you need to add a reference for the API contract in order to be able to use it. What is that API contract? It could be found in MSDN. And basically, when you open an API of UWP, you will see that information, device family, and API contract. The device family is actually the version of the Windows in which the API was released. And the API contract, you can imagine it that this is like a DOL that you need to add a reference to your project in order to be able to call the API. And after that, you simply need to call it. So I'm going to show a short demo. The demo is only for WPF, but all things I'm going to show today are also valid for WinForms as well. All right, I'm going to run now the demo. It's pretty simple. On the left side, you have a data grid that visualizes some amount of, All right. And I can see my demo. OK, here it is. Yeah. OK, this is a simple application that basically uses data grid control on the left side to visualize some data. And on the right side, you can see some very primitive UI for executing some CRUD operation with the application. CRUD means create, read, update, and delete. All right? So basically, I can select some item from the grid and simply to delete it. or I can add some new items to the data grid. What I'm missing actually here is some notification that the action was performed successfully or vice versa successfully. So what I'm going to use now is an API that is only part of the UWP framework, and it is called toss notifications. In order to be able to call that API, as I mentioned before, we need to add some references or API contracts. The mentioned API is part of the Windows Foundation contract and Universal API contract. I have already added them, and they could be found in C Programs Windows Kits. This is the default folder where the APIs are located after installing the needed SDK. All right. So now, a few words about my application. You have already seen it, but it's very simple. I have some XAML here that contains a grid and a few buttons. And I have some class called ViewModel. Basically, I tried to make it MVVM friendly, my application, but I wasn't able to make it successfully. However, I have some class that's called ViewModel, and here is of my logic. All right. So I have two methods that are called save or update order and add new order. And here I have some code that I'm going to uncomment. And what that code does is basically it creates some XML information about the stuff I'm going to present in the toss notification, creates a toss notification, and through the toss notification manager, I'm basically showing it. And now I'm going to run my demo. Okay. I will select the item and simply delete it. The expected result here is a crash, believe it or not. Why actually the application crashes? Sorry. All right. I have mentioned a few times the desktop bridge. The desktop bridge, as I mentioned, gives the ability to package your application and to deploy to the store. However, it gives you something more to us. It gives an identity to our app. Without that identity, some APIs like the toss notification could not be invoked from the WPF or the Windows Forms world. And now, I'm going to add that desktop bridge. When it was initially introduced, the desktop bridge was very hard to use because there was some command line application, and you have to know a few commands in order to be able to use it. However, nowadays, Microsoft has provided us a template which comes out of the box with Visual Studio. From the Windows Universal tab, you just need simply to create a new Windows application packaging project. And the mentioned identity could be found in the Apex manifest. Inside the packaging tab, you can see all the identity stuff that is part of the application. And after that, you need simply to add your WPF or Windows Form app as a reference to the desktop bridge app. And of course, make it startup project. It needs a few seconds to deploy. All right. So I'm selecting an item and simply deleting it. And you can't see it because it's on my second screen. But believe it or not, we have received a notification. All right. Okay. No. All right. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. But here are the notifications that are stored after they were sent to my computer. As you can see, some orders are deleted, or I can add one and to check it. Okay, here, some order has been added. Okay, now let's play with some other APIs. For example, I really like the speech recognition API. The speech recognition API is pretty simple. You need only to create an instance of the speech recognizer, wait for a window to pop up to use a microphone to tell your to speech to it, and after that to get the resulted text and make some actions with it. Oh, I forgot to uncomment some part of my UI where I'm actually invoking the speech recognition stuff. Okay. Okay, we have a button here. And after I press it, delete order. Wow, this was very fast. Delete order. And the order will be deleted. And a notification should be sent. Here it is. Order has been deleted. OK, the XAML Islands. A few months ago, that built in May, a guy from Microsoft came into the stage and said, OK, we gave you all the APIs of UWP, and you are able to use them from within your WPF or WinForms app. Using the package, the desktop reach, you can package your application and deploy it to the store. And the last thing that was missing was the UI. The UI was actually provided to be able to use it from the WPF app using the XAML Islands. XAML Islands were introduced officially a few weeks ago with the latest version of Windows. And some of the controls that are pure native UWP controls, like the web view and the in canvas, are already wrapped. And they could easily be used directly from within your app. Basically, you need to go to the Windows Community Toolkit repository, and you can see the different Nuget packages that they have there. For all the other controls, like the map control, the data grid control, button, and stuff like this, you can use the Windows XAML host. Windows XAML host gives the ability to basically wrap that controls into the WPF or WinForms world and use their APIs. Bindings could also be performed there. And now I'm going to show you a short demo about the XAML Islands. OK, the first thing, as I mentioned, is to add a specific reference in your application or to be able to use it. This is the Microsoft Toolkit WPF UI XAML host. And the other Nuget packages could be found in the Windows Community Toolkit. These are the guys that are actually developing the XAML Islands. And you can find lots of information here, including the source code of the XAML Islands. Okay, so now I'm going to include a specific window in my application. This is a WPF window that has a few things in its XAML declaration. A grid, an image, and Windows XAML host. Actually, this is the mentioned part where you can use to wrap all your existing other UWP controls that are not wrapped by the guys from the Windows Community Kit. So in code behind, I'm actually declaring a pure UWP controls. As you can see, we have grid, which has the same name as the grid here. But this grid is a pure WPF one, while this one is UWP, as you can see from the namespace. And I have some controls here, like map control. Map control is specific only for the UWP framework. Of course, there are some third-party controls that are providing map controls for WPF as well, but UWP gives it to you out of the box. And some other UI controls, like sliders, which gives me the ability to control some of the properties of the map control, are also added. These are, again, native UWP sliders. And basically, after I have prepared my UI, I need simply to call child. The child property needs to be set to the mentioned UWP grid. And that's all. So how that window actually looks like, I'm now going to show you. All right, again, I forget to uncomment some of my commented stuff in the XAML part. Here, as you have already seen, I have been using a text box control for changing my address, which is super simple, and it doesn't have a validation at all, so I'm going to remove that thing. And again, I add some button from which I'm going to open the mentioned window. All right. So after the button is clicked, a new window pops up. And here in the screen, you can see a few controls. These are the map controls and three slider controls. All of these controls are pure UWP controls. Using the sliders, I can perform some interaction with the map, the map above. And this is all of this is handled in the WPF application. I don't have any UWP app or something like that to extend the WPF app. And I can simply pick another address. And after saving it, it should be updated. Oops. And I should receive a notification. Maybe it's right there, but just can't see it. All right. So these are basically the XAML Islands. The team behind that functionality is still developing it. For example, it's really hard to wrap third-party controls using the islands. I have already tried that. And it's impossible, but the guys behind the feature are still improving it, and they have promised us that they're working on an easier to provide an easier functionality that you can use as a developer to wrap your controls and stuff like that. Okay. And now, one slide about the future of desktop development. Being a desktop developer nowadays is super awesome. You have, as you have seen, great variety of options from which you can choose to create your app, WPF, WinForms, and UWP, but many more things are coming. This is an official statistic from Microsoft. Actually, 2.4 million applications are building every month using Visual Studio desktop apps. And this is about a 50% increase comparing to the last 20 months. More controls will be added to UWP. As you have seen, Telerik has open source all of its controls. We are still developing them, and communities like the Windows Community Toolkit are building new control services, the XAML Islands, and stuff like that. So I believe more and more controls will come to the UWP world. More APIs with every version of Windows, more and more APIs are added, and these APIs are wrapped and could be used directly from within your WPF and UWP WinForms app. .NET Core 3.0. .NET Core 3.0 will support WinForms and WPF. That doesn't mean that your application will run in Linux or in Mac, but it will use the .NET Core for building purposes. It will become much faster as an application develop time. Comparing .NET Core 3.0 to .NET Framework, .NET 3.0 is much faster than the .NET Framework. And you can go to the repository of the .NET Core and to simply download the installer. And after it gets installed into your machine, you can easily use it. I will show you now that. OK. I have opened my command prompt. And here, I can simply execute the following command, .NET new WPF, which will create a new WPF application for me. And as you can see, we have here AppXAML main window, which is expected for an initial template of WPF. And if I run that application, you can see a WPF app that is built using .NET Core 3.0. Of course, you can play with that app. You can open it in your favorite editor. And play with the controls and stuff. This will be officially released, I believe, next year. So many great things are coming to the desktop world. And finally, I have already mentioned that, but the XAML Islands will continue its development. More and more native UWP controls will be wrapped. And I believe the support for third-party controls will be added as well. And basically, that's all, guys. So I'm open for questions. Yes? OK, the question was, what happens if you have map control and the application does not run on Windows 10 machine, right? OK, all the controls that are part of the universal Windows platform are developed in a way that they could only be used in Windows 10 machines. So UWP is technology that runs only on Windows 10. And because of that, all of its controls can run on Windows 10 machines only. Yes, yes. You cannot show a UWP control, pure UWP control, into a machine that runs in, for example, Windows 7, 8, or XP. Questions? OK, the question is, how my UWP controls communicate with the WPF world? Yeah, something like that. OK. This is a very interesting question. And in order to be able to answer it, I will need some more time. But if you check the Windows Community Toolkit and there is the code of the Windows XAML host, you will see that this is basically a framework element that wraps the UWP control. And you can, using it, you can initialize that control directly in the WPF world. And after that, if you have added the needed references, the API contracts I have already mentioned, you can simply initialize your control, make the bindings, invoke some events as well, properties and stuff like that, and simply to use it, because the control is actually wrapped into a pure framework element that is familiar for the WPF world. Questions? Yes? Yes? I have tried that. But before that, I should tell the question to the other guys. OK. In the demo, I have created my UWP controls in code behind. Is it possible to do it in XAML? Yeah. Well, I have tried that, but as I have mentioned, the XAML islands are still in development state, and there were some issues that made it impossible for me to create that controls in XAML. Basically, the idea behind the XAML islands is to create a UWP library, and inside that library to declare your controls inside a XAML page, for example. And after that, using a few commands to get the generated automatically caught by Visual Studio to reference it into your WPF app and simply to call it. For example, if you have a UWP library and, for example, call it My Controls, inside My Controls you have one page with all of the XAML decorations. After building that stuff, a file will be generated for you and you can reference it inside your WPF app and simply to call My Controls. But that was not possible for me. Even the documentation says that this should be possible right now, but they have some bugs, and I believe sooner or later they will be resolved, and many more stuff like wrapping third-party controls will be possible as well. But if you are building a WPF app and want to call some of the UWP controls, I suggest you to do it in code behind right now. Questions? Yes. The question was, do you believe the UWP controls will sooner or later be exposed and wrap all of them that, so they can be used from your toolbox? And I believe yes. Because some of the controls like WebView and InCanvas are wrapped. So you need to go add a reference to the package, and they will come to the toolbox, and you can simply drag and drop them. Yeah, just a matter of time. Actually, yesterday, I saw that the map control is mapped as well. So more and more controls are coming. Questions? Yes? Yes. OK, the question is, can the XAML islands run on every version of Windows 10? And the answer is no. You need to have the latest version of Windows, because the XAML islands uses some APIs that were introduced with that version. So you need to update your Windows sooner or later in order to be able to use them. Yes? OK, here the question is it possible to call an API that was introduced in earlier version of Windows? And is it possible that API to run? And the answer is, again, you cannot use that API if you're using an earlier version of Windows. But inside your application, you can check what version you're actually running and execute that app in order to prevent some crashes. So there is some possibility to prevent the crash, but not to use the API. And okay. Okay, why do you need to call UWP? Sorry, I was. Okay. Okay, the answer is, why do I need a UWP control in my WPF app? And I have already explained in my demo that, for example, map control is not part of the controls that are provided for WPF. It is only controls that's available in UWP. Also, every control UWP has a consistent look and feel with your operating system. The Fluent design team is integrated into those controls. So if you want to use that look and feel and make your application look similar to your Windows with the Fluent design, you need to use UWP controls. You can achieve that look with your WPF controls as well, but you need to do some work for that. Yeah, for example, web browser is also another control that is super powerful in the UWP world, and you can use it easily use it in your WPF application. Because there, the web browser is not so, so powerful, may I say. OK, more questions? Or? OK, guys, thank you. Have a nice evening.